Hello, welcome viewers to Elim TV, whereby we are going to interact and learn together. Now today's lesson is Biology Form 1, Lesson 9, whereby our topic will be the cell. And as you are aware that the cell is a basic unit of an organism, and the subtopic specialized animal cells. We have different specialized cells, but in this lesson we are going to deal with the specialized animal cells, and whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. Welcome and let us enjoy. We have our lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to draw and give functions of the specialized animal cells. We are going to have our first specialized cell, which will be the sperm cell. And as you can see from our diagram, the sperm cell, it has got the head, it has the acrosome, which is still on the head, it has the nucleus, the mitochondrion, which are spiral in shape, we have the middle piece, we have the plasma membrane, we have tail. As you can see from the diagram, the sperm cell is divided into three parts. That is, we have the head, we have the middle piece, and we have the rear part. Which is the rear part is normally made up of the plasma membrane and the tail. The middle piece is basically made up of a mitochondrion, and as you are aware that the function of the mitochondria is to provide energy. So the middle part of the sperm cell is the one that provides energy for it to be able to swim towards the ova. At the head, normally has got the acrosome, whereby basically the function of the acrosome. It will be used to enter the ova from the females. The sperm cell, it is the male gamete that affects the fertilization of the egg. It has a long tail like extension for propulsion, that is moving to reach the egg. It has numerous mitochondria to provide energy for propulsion. It also has an acrosome that contains lytic enzymes that digest the egg membranes to allow penetration of the head of the sperm into the egg. As you are aware that it's only one sperm that enters the female ova. So it is the function of the acrosome to go and digest the membrane of the ova. Once that membrane is digested, it develops a certain repulsive force such that there is no any other sperm that can enter there. Our second specialized animal cell will be the red blood cells, and as you can see, they contain the cytoplasm, which normally contains hemoglobin. I'm very sure that you are aware that hemoglobin contains with oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin. So the red blood cells are animal cells that form part of the cellular component of blood in animals. They are biconcave in shape, as you can see. They normally lack a nucleus, and they contain hemoglobin. The reason why they are lacking nucleus, this is for it to provide a large surface area such that hemoglobin could be carried. And these features enable them to transport oxygen within the body, and as you are aware that the oxygen, we require oxygen as living organisms too. For various functions in the body. Our third specialized animal cell will be the white blood cell. And as you can see from our diagram, we have different types of blood cells. The first type of blood cells is known as the neutrophil. You can see its shape. The second specialized white blood cell is the eosinophil, and you can see they are different shapes. The third one is the basophil, and you have the lymphocyte. We also have the monocyte. The white blood cells, like the red blood cells, they form another cellular component of blood in animals. They have large nuclei, and some have the ability to change their shape. As you can see, our blood cells here, they have different shapes. So they are able to change their shapes. They exhibit amoeboid movement. Whereby when you see amoeboid movement, it's like they slide, they go like by sliding when they are moving in the body. They protect the body against infections by destroying disease-causing microorganisms through antibody production or phagocytosis. These white blood cells, they protect the living organisms from contracting diseases. We have another specialized cell, which is the muscle cell. So you are aware that the muscles are the ones which are enable living organisms to move from one place to another, either in search for pasture or food or to seek shelter and several. So as you can see, we have the upper part, which is made up of the muscle fiber. We have the blood vessels, and the blood vessels are very different. We have the red blood cells, the white blood cells, and etc. We have the perimysium, we have the epimysium, we also have the fascicles, whereby the fascicles are normally wrapped by perimysium. We have also the endomysium. Normally, the endomysium, they are between the fibers. And now we have on the lower part, we have the tendons, and tendons are normally attached to the, bone. So these ones, they are found in animal cells where they facilitate for movement. They contain contractile fibrils that contract and relax, bringing about movement in living organisms. Having done those several specialized animal cells, we have the following activity which we are going to undertake. You give four types of specialized animal cells, and for that you also give their functions. For further reference on the specialized animal cells, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And you can also, for this and more information, you can contact us through an SMS. That is, you send us an SMS through the number that you can see from our screen, or you send us SMS through our Facebook page, which is at Elimu TV, or you tweet, or that is sending us a message through Twitter at Elimu TV _Kenya. Welcome, welcome much, and thank you for watching.